Welcome to my world. You think it's funny? GoFundMe stole $9 million from the truckers in Canada, you know, in their campaign for freedom against government forcing people to do something they don't want to do, like undergoing a medical procedure they don't want, making it mandatory. Whatever happened to freedom? Here in America, the same thing is happening. Mark Zuckerberg deleted the same thing, the truckers' anti-mandate freedom campaign. That's millions of dollars stolen from them. If you disobey, you get punished. And we have freedom of speech, too. And if you exercise your freedom of speech, you get canceled. You lose your job, and you might even go to prison. All of this, and it's so obvious. The authorities in Canada, the police standing there acting all pompous and professional, were looking into these unlawful acts, and these villains are going to be rounded up, and we've got 150 new officers working on this, and this will not be tolerated in our free country. It's so obvious, Forrest Gump would be able to see it. Is this a deliberate effort? Is this an experiment to see how far they can push people before they wake up and push back and outright disobey their government? Questioning your government is the highest form of patriotism. Any patriots out there? By the way, anybody know who John Roach is? Yeah, welcome to my world. You're getting a taste of what they've been doing to me all my life. How's it feel, boys and girls? Welcome to USSA, land of free, home of brave.
Look, I think that everyone is going to have to take a hard look at where they want to be at this moment in history, as we're looking at efforts across the country to prevent people from being able to exercise their fundamental rights. Go